Bonjour à tous. Hello everybody. Welcome to my channel. I'm glad that you are here.
Today, I'd like you to stroll around Old Montreal with me.
Old Montreal is a truly delightful part of the second biggest city in Canada, with historical buildings that give a special ambience to the district of Vieux Montréal, Old Montreal. Also, I'll show you the places where you can have really good poutine in Montreal. Poutine is a representative Quebecois food. Let's go. Allons-y. Old Montreal, or Vieux Montréal in French, is a historic neighborhood in Montreal in the province of Quebec, Canada. It is also the home to the Old Port of Montreal by the St. Lawrence River. The architectural beauties of Old Montreal blow my mind each time I go there. It is such an eye-pleasing place. Old Montreal was founded by French settlers in 1642 and home to many structures dating back to the era of New France, which was from 1534 to 1763. With some of its buildings dating to the 17th century, it is one of the oldest urban areas in North America. In the eastern part of the old city, the city hall is a great place to start your promenade to the waterfront, the old port of Montreal. It was built between 1872 and 1878 in the Second Empire style or Napoleon III style. The Montreal City Hall is one of the best examples of the Second Empire style in Canada. When you walk to Place Jacques-Cartier, you are entering to the old port of Montreal block. At the entrance of Place Jacques-Cartier, there is Nelson's Column, or La Colonne Nelson in French. It is a monument erected in 1809 in Place Jacques-Cartier and dedicated to the memory of Admiral Horatio Nelson following his death at the Battle of Trafalgar. Nelson's Column is the oldest war monument in Canada. Place Jacques-Cartier, or Jacques-Cartier Square, was named in honor of Jacques-Cartier, the French explorer who claimed Canada for France in 1535. There are many restaurants on both sides of the hill. It's very lively and filled with tourists and locals strolling among all kinds of street artists. The broad street slopes steeply downhill from Montreal City Hall and Rue Notre-Dame and to the waterfront, the old port of Montreal. Located adjacent to Old Montreal, the Old Port of Montreal stretches for over 2 kilometers along the St. Lawrence River. It was used as early as 1611 when French fur traders used it as a trading post. It is today a recreational and historical area and draws 6 million tourists annually. Along these 2 kilometers, there are over 100-year-old Montreal clock tower, pedalo and pleasure boating rentals, the tallest Ferris wheel in Canada, La Grande Roue de Montréal, and a 1,200-foot zip line course. If you continue to walk to the west for a few hundred meters, you arrive at the Place d'Armes Square facing Basilique Notre-Dame or Notre-Dame Basilica. The groundbreaking of the basilica took place in 1823. The facade of the church was completed in 1865. The Basilica offers musical programming of choral and organ performances. It is a tradition among many Montrealers to attend the annual performance of Handel's Messiah every Christmas. More than 11 million people visit Basilique Notre-Dame every year, only 1 million fewer than Notre-Dame de Paris. Surrounding buildings are New York Life Insurance Building, which was the first high-rise building in Montreal in 1889, the Bank of Montreal head office built in 1859,
and Canada's first Art Deco Alderite building completed in 1931. Oh, there is one more place you want to check out when you are in Old Montreal. Only a couple of hundred meters from the Old Port and by the end of Jacques-Cartier Square, there is a beautiful silver-domed building on St. Paul Street. It is the famous Marché Bon Secours, or Bon Secours Market in English. For more than 100 years, it was the main public market in the Montreal area since it opened in 1847. Since then, it has been transformed into a multi-purpose facility with a mall that houses outdoor cafes, restaurants, and boutiques on the main and second floors, as well as a rental hall and banquet rooms on the lower and upper floors. Old Montreal is a really charming part of the city you'd love to visit and go back. When you get hungry after a stroll, you can sit and enjoy food on a terrace at Jacques-Cartier Square, but in Montreal, you may want to have some great poutine. Poutine is a comfort food you can enjoy as a snack or a meal. Traditional poutine is a really simple food consisting of French fries, cheese curds, and brown gravy. You can have poutine really anywhere and everywhere in Canada. However, as poutine originated from Quebec in 1950s and is known as a Quebec food, there are a lot of casual restaurants and diners called poutinerie in Montreal where they serve amazing poutine. Freshness of the curds is essential. The fresh cheddar cheese curds make their characteristic squeaky sound when chewed. Air and moisture seep out of the curds over time, by which the curds lose their elasticity and therefore squeaky sound. You can buy cheese curds at almost any grocery store in Canada. Many poutineries or poutine restaurants have dozens of varieties of poutine on their menu. Many of these are based on the traditional poutine with added toppings such as sausage, chicken, bacon, brisket, or Montreal-style smoked meat, sautéed green peppers, and onion. Green Spot is an old-style diner where you can choose your poutine from more than a dozen varieties. You can order a small or a large size. Chez Claudette offers even more varieties in three different sizes. In Canada, all fast food restaurants like McDonald's, Burger King, and A&W also have poutine on their menu. And poutine is one of the most popular items at Costco food court across Canada. If you have fresh cheese curds, it's very easy to make poutine. I'll show you how to make a classic version. First, take out cheese curds from the fridge so that they will not be super cold. Bake or fry frozen French fries, or feel free to make French fries from scratch. Meanwhile, you make brown gravy. Ingredients: you need 2 cups of beef broth, 2 tablespoons of flour, 2 tablespoons of butter, 1 quarter teaspoon of garlic powder, 1 quarter teaspoon of onion powder, salt, and pepper. Melt the butter in a medium-sized pan and add the flour. Stir continuously for about 2 minutes until a thick paste forms. It is called roux. Add about a half cup of beef broth and stir vigorously with the roux until it's smooth and lump-free. Add the rest of the beef broth, onion powder, and garlic powder. Boil until thick and smooth about 3 to 4 minutes. Taste and season with the salt and pepper. Only if you want, you can season your French fries. Put them in a bowl or a soup dish. Top with the fresh cheese curds. pour very hot gravy over the cheese curds and french fries. They will not be melting completely. Voila! Then you can add meat or vegetables as well. I hope you can find fresh cheese curds wherever you watch this video from. That's all for today from me. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I'll be back with more useful and interesting information next week. Please do give this video a thumbs up if you have enjoyed it. I very much appreciate it. Please subscribe if you want to see more of my weekly videos. Thanks so much for watching.